Hi everyone, Andy here from Andy's Astro. I've got a box full of toys here to share, so you might be curious about what's in here, so what do you say we have a little look? Because this box has come to us all the way from Portugal to us here in Melbourne, Australia. So what do you think comes from Portugal that might be of interest to an astrophotographer? Well, let's find out. Lots of packaging. Lots of snow. Don't get too much snow in Australia. But this is pretty cool. It's like playing Russian dolls when you open up all these little boxes in here. So let's see what else we got. Another box. But wait, there's more. Another box. This might give a little bit of a hint to what's happening here. But wait, there's one more. Another box. Alright. Let's see what's in these boxes, huh? So, the guys at Attic and Vince and the crew have been very supportive. And they've been kind enough to offer me a little bit of an upgrade here of my imaging system. And I've never squeezed this beautifully packaged item out. This is the new Attic APX60. This is a full-frame CMOS digital astro camera in mono. And it's got some pretty cool features. So let's check it out. So first of all, it's full-frame. So, and it's got the Sony chip in it, so very super clean. It's got a USB hub here, which will make cable management a lot easier. My understanding is this will cool about 40 degrees below ambient. And it's also got a really nifty little, probably can't see this too well, it's got a built-in leveling plate. And that basically means that if you're trying to correct the tilt over a wide frame, you can tweak this, but not only can you tweak it, you can tweak it as you're imaging and test it. So you can give it a little tweak, take a shot, okay, a little bit of it back the other way, a little bit of a tweak. So you don't have to dismantle the entire imaging train just to get rid of tilt. Tilt has been the bane of my life, so it's good to know that. In addition to that, there's the Allen key that works with that. Obviously some cabling and so on and so forth. All right, what's in this box, you might ask? This is the Attic off-axis guider. So it's designed as a complete imaging system with the cameras and so forth. And with this little gadget, you've got a little pick-off prism here. So your light travels down through the telescope, and it hits the prism, and then it... sorry, I've got it upside down. And then it's shot up to where your video camera is, which is your guide camera. And the rest of the light obviously travels through the camera. Nifty little system, and we'll look forward to putting that into place. The guide camera itself, guys at Attic have come up with the Attic Infinity Black. So this is a little bit, in some ways, overkill for a guide camera, but it's supposed to be like the bee's knees of this sort of thing, and it'll make a highly sensitive, very effective guide camera. Slightly unusual design and shape, as you can see, but basically it'll just sit comfortably here, and it will then lock in to the image and send micropulses through to the mount, which will keep that image within one pixel on the frame. And finally, in the biggest box, we have Attic's EFW3. Sealed up here. So this is the filter wheel that goes with the camera. Let me just prise this open. The packaging is good, guys. Not going to be a birthday present, isn't it? But just to give you a sense of... So that's not huge. It's a reasonable cut size. And this accommodates the 2-inch filters that I use from Chroma on my imaging system. So this attaches to this, which attaches to this, and it all goes together. So I've got to get a couple of adapters manufactured. That's today's job. And then hopefully we'll get the first light on this thing in the next week or so. If it all goes together well, we'll post up some images. And obviously feel free to drop your thoughts in the comments, and I'll let you know how it all goes, putting all this together. It's going to be a lot of fun. Just want to big shout out to the guys at Attic. Thanks so much. Thanks, Vince. Legend. Thanks, Rui.